set to pull. David Janinas for the San Francisco Dogfish. Referee signals game time. And we're off. Janinas with a sweeping pull downfield, almost making it to the end zone. The wind is going right to left, near to far as we look at it. Disc centers to Tridiac. Deep cut up in the middle and a horizontal stack. Poach off the handler. Swung over and upfield to Burton. Burton looking down the line, finds an inside shot. And a lofty flick, sailing. Deed easily by the Dogfish.
Jackson Stearns with that D.
Jackson Stearns with the D, swinging it over on the sideline. A little bit of a messy offense so far for the Dogfish, but they're running it through their handlers. Good pressure from the Rainmakers. Big swing out. Rainmakers pushing the Dogfish back well into their own end zone. Floaty flick, can't hang on. And the Dogfish will have a chance to break right on the goal line. 1 minute into this game. The Dogfish coming off a 1-1 season so far. Rainmakers, scuba from Tridiac over to the side for a score. 1-0 Rainmakers. Eddie Feely pulls it for the Rainmakers. Dogfish activating the play. Up the middle, that's Kissman. Kissman back over to McGurk. McGurk, huge hammer over the top. Chasing defense, cannot get there. Gabe Sonke on the line, finds his teammate for the goal. Gap in the Rainmakers' defense lets the Dogfish get away with it. Andrew Hooker sends the pull down for the Dogfish. 1-1, 8:33 remaining in the first period. Pull is centered. Jeff Pape over to Danny Tridiac. Tridiac, one of the three captains for the Rainmakers. Up the line, there's Burton, another one of the captains. Looks up line, looks off the deep cut. Squirrely handler movement, centered back to Tridiac. Tridiac launches a flick, Burton released into the end zone. Goal if he catches it, he does. Goal for the Seattle Rainmakers. 2-1 against the Dogfish. Goal goes up for the Rainmakers. Dogfish setting up a side stack.
Ben Whipple with that pull.
Nick Thompson out in the lane. Isolated, doesn't get it. Side stack breaks open. Having a run back again from the handlers and an unfortunate drop for the Dogfish. Looks like Kissman couldn't hang on. Eddie Feely picks up, looking for a Rainmakers break. Fires a super bladey flick. Gonna be hard to reel that one in. And Peter Bender cannot get there. Little ambitious.
Eddie Feely overthrew that one.
Interesting to watch. D teams on O, sometimes very patient in moving it, but often, more often than not, looking to fire a quick one and make the offense bleed. Dogfish back in their own end zone again. Last time that happened, they were forced into a turnover. This time they come out of the end zone, but most of their players behind the disc right now. Malcolm hacked out in the lane, the only one down there. Now they recovered. Big swing across, nice throw upwind. Couple of fakes, doesn't go. Bounce, pounce, Eddie Feely makes sure he gets the D, and a little bit softer touch on that flick for the Rainmaker break.
Eddie Feely with the pull.
Eddie Feely pulls it. Rainmakers up two breaks, Dogfish center. Horizontal stack, very deep right now. Finds an opening up the middle. Defense cheats, another open guy for the Dogfish, swinging it all the way over. There's Kissman. Kissman looking up the middle. Nice poachy D off the handlers, forcing a big swing, floating, but easily caught. Whole offense very deep right now, swings out. Up the middle again, almost D'd by a poach. Good pressure from the Rainmakers, but the Dogfish hanging on, looking up the sideline, throwing it up the sideline, a little too far inside. Looks like Neely with the D. Swings out to Henry Fan. messy offense, but it looks like contact on that one. And there is a call, and one called from the crowd. And he'll take yards for the contact.
That was a marking foul. But a nice catch by Eddie Feely.
Offense initiates up the middle of the horizontal stack. Handler's back, there's Fan. Fan with a scuba over the middle, easily caught. Still in horizontal, big hammer into traffic, but sneaking through, it looks like Clay Dewey Valentine reels it in for the Rainmaker break, and as they go up 4-1, 5:38 remaining to play in the first. Pull is up for the Rainmakers. Dogfish definitely hoping not to get broken again this point. Three breaks for the Rainmakers so far. Henry Fan's poaching out into the lane. Oh, it looks like actually a zone up front on the handlers. Now they pick up, transition, but still poachy off the handlers as the Dogfish starting to find their rhythm and a whistle on the field. Looks like a foul on the D as Peter Bender made contact and then got tripped up. Disc up, a little dishy. Jaeger holsters it. Nice grab by Arthur Fitzgerald Sheridan. Thomas Cook Adams on the sideline, gets it off. A little floaty, but easily caught. Nice swing out, Bender chasing. Lefty flick, gonna float. Oh, and watching the line, towing it but not catching it, it looked like Andrew Hooker.
The throw from Jackson Stearns just outside the back.
Eddie Feely will initiate the transition offense for the Rainmakers, looking to get their fourth break here. Nice yardage gainer up into the middle. Adam Klein with it, swings it out. Looks like Beener. Oh, some contact on the catch. Another and one. Fan will take it a few yards up, but to continue the offense. Launches a big shot. Double coverage, grabs it, toes the line, but ruled out by the referees. Great attempt with pressure from the D.
It was a good effort by Evan Klein.
Evan Klein could not keep it in bounds. And the Dogfish will get another
chance.
On
the throw from Henry Fan.
More poaching off the handlers, forcing a long flick swing. They opt for the shorter flick swing and get it up into the middle. Over to the open guy who was left open by the poached handlers. Huge throw out into space. No Rainmakers nearby. And David Abram pulls that one in easily, unguarded. A nice throw out to space. Cover to the other side of the field. Rainmaker defense jogging and chasing. Dogfish wisely move it off the line. Jaeger swings it over. Hooker with the disc, back to Jaeger. They're pushed out by Rainmaker D now, a little outside of the end zone. No cuts right now, but another hammer, a lot of hammers so far today, could not hang on. And another turnover as the Rainmakers will regain possession. Seen a couple hammers work so far, that one a little low. And a timeout call, these teams have been trading possessions. Need a little breather. Just back in after the timeout. Wise double team on the throw or on the corner. Now the Rainmakers with it in the middle of the field, single coverage. Tridiak moves it, quick movement there. Bailey, back over to Bailey. Bailey over to Tridiak. No dumps, everything's upfield. Getting into trouble, sends a scuba up the line, sneaks it over. Looks like McKibben. McKibben, floaty flick back to Tridiak. Burton takes off, but there's double coverage deep. Another big hammer. John Quant gets it. Moves it upfield to Bailey. Bailey looking for help. Little lefty flick, diving defender, but Tridiak hangs on for an easy backhand to Burton for the goal. Rainmakers go up 5-1 with 1:26 remaining in the first.
Ben Whipple with the mighty pull.
Ben Whipple, biggest pull we've seen so far today. Dogfish again with a side stack. But a spread out defense from the Rainmaker is going to send it right back up to the handlers. Lassiter turns it to the middle of the field. Good pressure on the mark there from Clay Dewey Valentine. Swings over. Launch goes up. A nice throw to an open cutter. Caught. Leslie Simmons couldn't get there. And another hammer. It looks like there was contact on that throw. A hand-blocked hammer is not something you see every day. Nice defense from the Rainmakers as they will look for their fifth
break. Turns it back over for the Rainmakers.
Now some poachy D in the middle from the Dogfish. Finds the poach. Well done. Swing over. Through traffic. Nearly to Fan. Cutter too deep already for Fan to get it there. Beener with a nice grab. Sliding down. Beener looking to get it off the line. Does. Finds Dewey Valentine. Swings it over. Looks like Neely. Neely into Fan. Good movement from the handlers here. Let's see if they can get some movement downfield. There's a shot downfield. Slow for continuation, but launches it as Neely takes off. There's a lot of blade on that. Will he get there? And he does! A huge layout grab for the fifth break for the Rainmakers. Neely scores. Pull goes up. Shorter pull here from the Rainmakers. Dogfish looking for their O to score. They scored early on, and it's been a series of breaks from the Rainmakers, led largely by good handler pressure. Now the Dogfish off and running a little bit. Also some unfortunate drops for the Dogfish. Nice swing out, but too high, can't get there. Another turnover from the Dogfish, and the Rainmakers will have another chance. Eddie Feely running to the disc, initiating it because there's only 3-2-1 left. That's not gonna make it to the end zone. Is caught, but no goal. And the first period ends, Rainmaker 6.
And that brings us to the end of the first quarter.
Point Six Socks, the official sock sponsor of Major League Ultimate. Check out www.pointsix.com for their full line of performance merino wool socks. Go to discstore.com to purchase official merchandise of Major League Ultimate. Game discs, apparel, accessories, and more. Discstore.com is the world's premier supplier of Ultimate Frisbee products and the official store of the MLU. Discstore.com, that's discstore.com. Is pain stopping you from playing your best? Get rid of your pain and get back to your game at G-Sports Physical Therapy, the experts in sports rehabilitation. Visit our website today at gsportsphysicaltherapy.com.
6-1 Rainmaker lead. Rainmakers suffered the worst loss of the MLU season so far. It was their first game against the Portland Stags. Second game was closer, but another loss. Here they got to be feeling a little better, but still looking to put a W on the board. So don't expect them to try anything too new. They'll just put it away as they start with a side stack. Danny Tridiak. Everyone comes across, making room for Akai. Shoots it up to Mark Burton, man defense. Folks quite far away. And Danny Tridiak takes a long shot over to 6'6 Isaac Entz, who bodies out. Fans set to pull for the Rainmakers. The Dogfish responds to Tridiak. I'm not sure they have a response to Tridiak, a thrower who can just put it anywhere. You saw Tridiak throwing that last one to Isaac Entz. As Seattle comes down in a cup. Not used to seeing that. As you can tell by the throws, it's not too windy. If anything, the wind is going across, but as you saw by that hammer to Shanka, you can still hammer it upwind, so the wind's not too strong. They're doing upside down all day. As they find it, looks like Boucher in the middle, dishing it up. Only about 15 yards from the end zone. Shanka with the disc, moving it over close sideline. Still a man defense. They did an all right job transitioning from the zone, but once that zone got broken open, I think they weren't trying too hard. As the O marches it in to bring it 7-2, little victory for the Dogfish. Jaeger D-line pulling for Dogfish. Dug themselves into quite a hole from the offense getting broken so many times in that first quarter. down five. Defense have pretty serious weight on their shoulders for the Dogfish. They're going to have to break back and back and back to pull themselves back into this game.
Out of bounds near the brick mark. Disc comes back to the center.
Center that field. Man defense. There's going to be a play call as Johnny Quant is set up isolated. He cuts forward. Everyone seems to clear to the same side. Tridiak a little stuck with the disc. Tries to move it over to Lynch. But there's a turnover. As Jaeger's going to pick up the disc and try to get that first break back necessary. But it's macked almost immediately by Pape. Lynch comes and cleans it up. Intended receiver Abram never got there. Lynch with the disc. Moves it up that sideline to Johnny Quant. Who hits Mark Burton. Mark Burton, one of the lead scorers for Seattle. And in a rare turn of events, you have Burton throwing to Tridiak. And Tridiak tries some kind of double helix boat hammer, which obviously doesn't work. And now, despite having 8 minutes left in the quarter, they seem to be playing a game of 500. And milks it almost to the line, straddles it. Just on the line, needs to find anybody open at 7 seconds and calls a timeout. To make
time
sure they put this
San
one
Francisco.
In, which would be a second break in a row for San Francisco. This timeout was called on the goal line. He'll have 7 seconds to put it just 2 inches ought to do. As they take the opportunity of the timeout to switch O's and D's, you see the O line coming in for Dogfish. D line for Seattle, starting with a double team right now. Hoping for a hand blocked hammer like last time. Nice try, a little contact. But the hammers to the right side of the field are working today. Dogfish D doing quite well, having very few opportunities and managing to break ones. That wind's even died down a bit. It's still slightly crosswind going away from the screen. But even at its maximum, it wasn't too powerful, and now it's even died down further. Not helpful for the D. As Seattle goes into a horizontal stack, nobody seems to pick up Mark Burton. Burton takes that, shoots immediately to Brad Hauser. Nice shot, hits Hauser in stride.
Mark Burton to Brad Hauser.
Seattle pulls. See Evan Boucher coming down the close sideline for the Dogfish. He's been one of the star players in the league this year. As he takes off running, number 34, you see him going. Throw's not going to come up as he's double teamed. Seattle has done a great job so far neutralizing him. You haven't seen him having too much power this game. Right now with the disc, marked by Quant. Boucher has gotten quite a bit of yards, but has been really kept out of the end zone pretty successfully by the Seattle defense. Disc on the far sideline. Man defense as Dogfish, who've done this several times, lose yards to get it to a handler just to get it off a sideline. And the downfield cutters don't come up with him, stranding a handler back there. They have moved it up now. And there we find Boucher in the end zone. 8-4, bringing the Dogfish back in this game. Number 14, Andrew Hooker, pulling for San Francisco. That pull not using any of the small amount of wind as it curls towards us. Kimmon gets the disc, centers to Tridiak as usual. Horizontal stack quite deep for Seattle as they clear room for Burton underneath. Burton you'll see getting the disc a lot underneath as people are so afraid of him going deep. Danny Tridiak fires it into the end zone. Picks that close lip on just a little bit of that soft wind that's blown away from us. And floats over the head of four ultimate players. That's another turnover earned by that Dogfish defense as they set up in a horizontal stack. Again trying to make room. Great bid there by Cam Bailey. Can't get it. As Hooker has the disc now, fires a deep shot right away. Can Sheridan bring it down? Sheridan gets a hand on it and gets it. He got that. Sheridan got a hand on that, hit the ground, caught it again, and then scoops it in for the score. Another bank Dogfish, 8-5. We're seeing momentum definitely back with the Dogfish. This game opened 6-1 as Seattle just started rolling the Dogfish, caught a bit unawares, couldn't get their offense in line. Now the Dogfish defense are clawing their way back. 8-5. Center to Jeff Pape. You're seeing a bit of change up on the Seattle lineup as they got broken. far sideline. Looks like Quant, man defense. Cutter's quite deep in horizontal stack. Cutter's about 20, 25 yards away. Finds Quant underneath. Contact right away. Quant jumps up. Dogfish player still down. Shaking hands. That looks like Chung that hit the ground. They're calling no foul as Cheng's now on the mark. Disc moves to Mark Burton. Burton, who, as usual, throws and goes. Tough guy to keep up with. Little dish from Kai up to Pape. Pape stuck on this sideline as Hauser bails him out, but now Hauser's stuck on the sideline. Attempts to shoot it up to, it looks like, Cam Bailey, but broken up real nicely there by Adams, who gets that D, but they fired away.
Can't that was find a big McCarty. D by James Yeager, but then a throwaway.
Sorry, that was Yeager with the D, it looks like. He then tried to shoot it right away, as D-lines often do, but to success this time. Everybody behind the disc except Burton. Burton unable to get open. There he finds him now. Burton dishing it up. Nice break mark to Johnny Quant. He's got to hit low but can't get it. Might have actually been easier if the disc were further away so he could fully extend. Instead had to half extend and try to scoop underneath him. Couldn't get it. McCarty on the near sideline as absolutely nobody is on Stearns. Kai picks him up. Stearns stuck with the disc. McKibben caught not looking. Dishes it back. Yeager back to Hooker, going all the way across to Renahan. Back to Yeager, very deep four cutters. They're all 25 yards deep at this point. But McCarty finds it underneath. 15 yards to go. A little dishy, and it's just perfectly floated in that far sideline as Stearns is able to bring it in. 8-6. Dogfish clawing their way
Jackson
back.
Jackson Stearns with that score.
Seattle
and another.
Ahead,
San Francisco
but have to be nervous
great
at this point with the momentum so heavy in Dogfish territory. They're still down. Definite tide on their side. And they just want to make sure they keep putting those breaks in, keep demoralizing the Seattle offense. Nice pull goes. Hits the back of the end zone and rolls out. As McKibben takes a new disc, brings it from the very back of their field. So Andrew Lynch still with the disc, center of his own end zone. As Entz gets it on the far sideline. Lynch with the disc, lets it rip. It's gonna be a game of 500, hoping Entz can beat out Stearns. As the disc just floats too close. Entz hoping for a foul, none called. Entz, Quant, Stearns, and Adams. That is a nasty game of 500 to get into. Average height there is about 6'4". And the Dogfish take off with a rip right away. Beautiful shot to Boucher. Boucher finding his legs, finding the end zone, and finding another break. 8-7, 1-point game. Dogfish pulls coming up from Janinas. High floaty pull, it's gonna land before hitting the far sideline. Disc can't even be centered right now as nobody's on Eddie Feely. Feely, not too many points this game so far. Henry Fan with the disc center of the field. Lots of motion. Man defense, very nice bid by Cheng, and Cheng is down on the ground. He looks like his shoulder hurts. That could be a problem. Hit the ground shoulder first. Got a medic coming up. He's on the ground, not moving that shoulder. We'll see what happens and hope for the best. Disc coming in with Henry Fan. Man defense. As there's a lot of good movement here. Defense sticking quite tight. Never being too far off their guys unless they're behind the disc, in which case they often flash out into the lane. So far you're not seeing too much double teaming, the kind of double teaming that Seattle especially likes to do on those sidelines. Pickle with the disc, a little stuck as he finds Eddie Feely downfield, but not many gain yards until he finds Simon. Dish back to Feely. Feely just has to jam it in that end zone, but too many people there. As Pickle and it looks like Sleva fly into that end zone. two defenders follow. One of them realizes there's too many defenders here, drops back.
Finds Sam Pickle out in the end zone.
Until Feely can hit him. For the goal, 9-7, Seattle. Seeing both teams take the field. Timeout called between the halves by the Rainmakers, so they're going to get that half field pull. 2 minutes left in the half. This has been a pendulum game so far as the ball swung from the Rainmakers' side over the Dogfish. Unfortunately, that injury to Cheng can really take the wind out of sails mentally and emotionally for a team. So I'm guessing we're going to start with momentum pretty much back to flat as the Dogfish receive halfway in their own end zone, down two with 2 minutes left in the half. Disc far sideline, deep cutters. So much space being used on the field, it's not clearly a horizontal or vertical stack. It's just a lot of people giving each other lots of room to work with. Forcing a lot of one-on-ones downfield. The shot goes up, it's gonna be hanging, as it's gonna be a battle. Boucher, can he get there? And everyone a bit surprised. As Evan Klein comes out of nowhere. Knocks that disc before it gets down to Boucher.
That looked like Sam Berkelhammer on that D.
You see Neely at that far sideline, just gained about 30 yards. Fakes the flick as the disc goes off and almost picked up by Pickle. Dogfish gonna try to clean this up. No more turns here. As Kissman finds the far sideline. Looking upfield, finds Boucher. Pass to diving Dewey Valentine, it looks like. And gets it to Gabe Shonka in that far corner of the end zone. Bring it back within one, took a minute 20.
Gabe 43 Sonke seconds brings left it down for another
43 seconds left, 9-8. You see the pull there by Jaeger.
And that pull was by James Jaeger.
Gets centered to Pape right away. 40 seconds left. Seattle wants to, well, maybe just shoot it in right away. As that's a pretty floating throw to Cam Bailey, who wastes no time. 34 seconds left. That was about 10 seconds to put one in for the Rainmakers. Crowd likes it. 10-8. Giving the Dogfish a good half minute to work it downfield and bring it back within one before the end of the half.
From Jeff.
Whipple pulling. There's too much time on the clock really to play a prevent defense, so you're not going to see people hanging back just trying to prevent that 4 second hook. If they did, Dogfish would work it down the field as they're doing right now. Shonka close side to Thompson. Finds Weiss in the middle. Back to Thompson. 20 seconds left. Still lots of time. Oh, almost deed by Dewey Valentine, who's had about 4 bids this game, hasn't hit the disc on that one yet. It's got to be in the heads of the Dogfish. As Shonka with 6 seconds left, 4 seconds left, somebody's got to shoot it at the end zone. There's the hammer. That might work. And it does. Great grab by Lassiter to bring it within one for the Dogfish, closing out this
and
half.
And the hammer finds Thomas Lassiter.
Canterbury, the official apparel supplier to Major League Ultimate. Dress like a pro. Visit www.canterburyus.com, the destination for all your team's custom uniforms and athletic apparel needs. Canterbury, proud partner of Major League Ultimate, committed to the game. Stop your hands from sweating and increase your performance with Gamer Grip. This non-sticky solution allows you to make better throws and grab better catches without a hint of slippage. Innova is proud to support Major League Ultimate and its incredible athletes. As the official disc of the MLU, the Innova Pulsar has quickly become the disc of choice at Ultimate's highest level. Visit InnovaDisc.com to find a dealer near you. Wear the same Ultimate gloves as the pros. Friction Gloves helps your throws and catches in all conditions. To find out more information and get a pair, visit FrictionGloves.com.
So AJ did is doing
Rainmaker
great stuff.
Set to pull here, coming into the second
next
half.
Tuesday, May 5th,
pull goes up.
In the Seattle Foundation's 10-9,
Rainmakers.
You should have all gotten flyers.
As some participants in the All Girl Everything Ultimate program supporting South End Seattle Ultimate are talking to the crowd here. You might hear them talking in the background. Nice D, but caught by Thompson, moving it up the field. There's Kissman. Nice forward step. Get momentum. Dogfish get on the board right away, tying the game up at 10-10. Coming right strong into the second half. Dogfish to pull. Wind moving right to left. Kind of gusty, not too much wind. Pull goes right to the end zone line. Tridiak centers to McKibben. Horizontal stack. Kind of static. Not a lot of action having to go back through the handlers. Pape, McKibben, and Tridiak back. Moves up to Lynch. Not a lot of continuation looks. Sneaks it up the line to Tridiak. Tridiak looking back to the middle of the field, looking to get it off the line. Finds, looks like Hauser up line. Into Burton. Hauser takes off. Burton wisely looks back to him. Just outside the end zone line. Hauser swings over to big man Isaac Gantz. And with a little inside out, backhand break to Pape for the Rainmakers goal. 11-10 Rainmakers.
Isaac Gantz.
Rainmakers pull. Big floaty pull. Hustling down to get under.
Evan Klein with that.
Evan
nice
Klein pull. To their end zone line or near. 2 yards out for the Dogfish. Dogfish move it up easily. Up to Thompson. Thompson up line, but a little low. Kissman could not dig it out of the turf. And the Rainmakers will take the disc. Nice swing. Caught. Play Dewey Valentine getting it off the line. Feely, after a diving catch, moves it upfield. Beener and Dewey Valentine back to Feely. Feely looks off the swing. Punches it back to the line to Beener. Beener back to Feely. Should really be looking for this swing here, but has been successful so far at moving it up that line. Disc now in the hands of Pickle. Pickle finds Dewey Valentine, who skips into the goal for a goal. Rainmakers as they go up 12-10 with a little break. Henry Fan winds up and rips the Seattle pull. Not going to make it to the end zone line, but it does stay in bounds.
Henry Fan on that pull.
Nice pressure, but the Dogfish swing it out, off and running. Contact on the mark, not called, as Boucher moves it up to Kissman. Kissman swinging it out to Hecht. Nice movement from the Dogfish out to the line and then back to the middle, looking for that swing. Wisely swinging it across. It's a long swing. Heck moves it back. Kissman into the middle of the field. Dangerous position now for the Dogfish. Rainmakers need to tighten up the D. Neely getting turned around there. As Kissman gets open and gets the disc in the middle, and looks like there's a call on the field. Nice movement so far at this point by the Dogfish. Contact foul.
And it's a turnover.
A turnover. Rainmakers will take possession of the disc. Heading 70 yards upwind. Fan picks it up. Horizontal stack. Initiated by Neely. Low flick, but reeled in by Neely. Pumps a big one back to Fan. Bender open, but a little poachy off the handler. Doesn't allow it to go through. Dewey Valentine gets it, finds a nice runner. Little high, some contact down there. Not a great throw. Turning it over for the Rainmakers, and the Dogfish will get another attempt as Kissman picks it up. Dogfish sometimes slow to initiate their offense. This time, a nice inside-out flick over to Hecht. Oh, and a lazy dump attempt to catch that by McGurk gives the Rainmakers the disc back. Fan. Over to Pickle, back to Fan. Looping it up to Beener, who brings it down for the Rainmakers' break, beating his chest. Gorilla goal for the Rainmakers, who take the lead 13-10. Evan Klein to pull for the Rainmakers. Pull goes up. A little wobbly off the pull there. Comes up a little short. Dogfish with their side stack. Something poachy downfield for the Rainmakers as they fall into man. A lot of contact around the mark there. Sort of both a pick and a foul. And then a floaty one that Sheridan cannot retrieve. Lynch to Feely. Refs stop the play. Looks like a timeout from Rainmakers coach Steve Gusson. Teams take the field again following a Rainmakers timeout. Some personnel change. D team subbed out for some old players. Tridiak with the disc. Sends one immediately up to Burton. Double coverage. Burton showing some, as if he were pushed off with contact. The ref agrees. Burton will take the disc at the point that he would have received that pass at. Scrambling end zone offense. I don't know if I can call that end zone offense. End zone chaos. Disc finally in. So the chaos, not too detrimental. Finds McKibben. Looking back to Burton, then moving it over to Tridiak. Burton still looking to get open in the front of the end zone. Tridiak floats to McKibben. Burton shook his man and finds the opening for the goal. And they found him. The timeout pays off. The O team punches it in to take the lead. 14-10 with another Seattle break. Whipple pulling for the Rainmakers. Pulling upwind. 14-10 Rainmakers. 5:08 remaining in the third period. Dogfish need to put on a run here to get back in the game. Not a lot of initiation out of their offense. Finally, finding Boucher. Launching a flick. Feely's there. And Feely gets the D. Gabe Sonke could not come up with that disc.
Eddie Feely with the big D, skying the big man.
Feely slices a flick upfield. Bender. And another launch, this time with defense again in position. Both players going up and coming up short, and the Dogfish will reclaim possession. These floaty ones not really paying off. Deep stack here, not really a formed stack. Again, the Dogfish struggling to initiate well on their offense. Punched back into their end zone now. Over to the sideline. Cutter takes off, the defense reacts, so stuck on the sideline still. Finally, chucking a hammer. Streaking defender cannot get there. As the Dogfish are off and running, but now the entire team behind the disc. Sanke up the middle. Oh, to a diving acrobatic play and a second chance goal. The diving Mac. Dogfish pull goes up. Nice pull in the conditions. Seattle Rainmakers.
That pull was by Chris McCarty.
McCarty's pull. Pulled down and centered to Tridiak. Scoober ill-advised and ill-executed. Cross field right to the Dogfish, who could certainly gain some momentum back with a break here. Moving the disc quickly. Double team now. Jaeger gets it off to his dump. Janinis moves it up. Lefty inside out backhand. Another double team coming. And a clever little defensive play there leading to the stall. Credit that one to Tridiak. But they're going to take it back
on stall count
at the position where the stall happened, so the Rainmakers will not get to fast break there. But great, clever D from Tridiak, double teaming and then releasing to guard the dump. Hands to Lynch. Lynch step through, flick, finds Hauser. Hauser on the line. The Rainmakers sometimes struggling to move it off the line. Nice bid, and oh, it looks like he either got a piece or caused Pape to lose control of the disc. The Dogfish reclaim possession.
A D by James Jaeger.
Panetta turfs it. Rainmaker's disc. Several turnovers so far this point. 2 minutes remaining in the third period. Pape sees an open Lynch. Lynch sees he's open and walks it in for the goal. Rainmakers go up 15-11 with just under 2 minutes remaining in the third period. Henry Fan winds up the pull for the Rainmakers, who have a 4-point lead with 2 minutes, just under 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Dogfish, relatively unguarded here, taking advantage, moving it up the field easily as the Rainmakers are just chasing, now having to go backwards for the first time. McGirt swinging it out to Riggs. Riggs over to Fisk. Fisk, nice little shot up the line here to Boucher. Boucher, a lot of touches here today for the Dogfish. Dogfish swinging it across the field very nicely. Let's see if they can capitalize. The continuation not there in the end zone. The one cutter there came out of the end zone. And now the dump pass sails overhead. Neely picks it up, launches it out in front. That's going to work. To Klein into the goal. Great Rainmakers, 16-11. There's the fast break for the Rainmakers. Pull goes up for the Rainmakers. Nice pull.
That was Ben Whipple on the play.
Ben Whipple sends it right to the end zone line. For the Dogfish. Dogfish moving it through the handlers. Credit some of the Dogfish's troubles initiating their offense to some squirrely sort of poaching downfield D by the Rainmakers. Whistle on the field. Possibly contact there on the cutters. Not exactly sure of the call, but the Dogfish will advance the disc and put it back into play. Poached off the handlers. Disc moves over.
Contact downfield call.
Swings back. No dump available for Lassiter. Finds a slice inside and gets it back. Every other pass is going through Thomas Lassiter at this point. Until now. But the Dogfish easily march it up right to the end zone line. See if they can punch it in. Loose defense there by the Rainmakers, and the Dogfish capitalize to get their 12th point with only 12 seconds remaining in the third period. The Rainmakers, 12 seconds to try and get a goal in here to close out the period. Andrew Hooker, Lady Hole, backhand, 12 seconds remaining in the period. Diving Tridiak picks it up. They want to advance it quickly and then probably send something into the end zone. 9 seconds, 8 seconds, seven. Moving it out to Burton. Burton has to do something, launches it up. It's possible, but deed by three Dogfish defenders. That'll close out the third period of play. Rainmakers up 16 to the Dogfish 12.
CanJam, proud sponsor of MLU 2015. CanJam is a fast-paced disc game perfect for the backyard, tailgating, or warming up for Ultimate. Get CanJam today at the team store or online at canjam.com. Use bonus code ULTIMATE for 10% off your purchase. Skippy, the official peanut butter of the MLU, made with the funnest peanuts ever. Skippy yippee! Do you have an athletic event, team trip, or corporate outing coming up? If so, charter a private bus, minibus, or party bus from U.S. Coachways. Bus travel is one of the safest, greenest, and most comfortable ways to get your group to an event. If you're going with a group, trust U.S. Coachways. That's what we do.
Fans excited to start off this final quarter. As the momentum is swung back to the home team, Seattle Rainmakers, up 16-12. 4-point deficit, nothing that can't be cured in a quarter, as we saw from the first quarter and the second quarter. Third a little more even. Back to Seattle's side as Pape takes the disc, fires it over to Laws. Sorry, Bailey on the close sideline. Sticks in Bailey's hands a little bit, and right away we're going to see a break opportunity for the Dogfish. Dogfish setting up sort of horizontal stack. Launch goes up. Question is, can Stearns pull that down? And instead, looks like House is going to catch it as if it were intended for him. Straight up, it's going to be deja vu with Bailey on the near sideline. And deja vu again, where Bailey gets that disc stuck in his hand a little bit, releases it late. This time, House unable to get there, as it looks like Sheridan picks up the disc on that close front corner, bringing it 16-13, kicking off that fourth quarter with a break for the Dogfish. A lot of the same faces in for the Dogfish, no surprise, they just succeeded in the break.
James Yeager.
A lot of the same faces in for the night, for the Seattle team, for the Rainmakers. As they figured those were just a couple little throwaways, execution errors, no real problem. Let's get you back on your feet. Pape with the disc in the middle of the field, horizontal stack. Coming close to McKibben, back to Pape. Pape has an opportunity, but looks off Burton streaking deep as Burton's on the near sideline. Nice D-bit there from Yeager, but it leaves McKibben open with any shot he wants as that D-bit took away the mark.
Jeff Pape to Brad Hauser.
Finds Hauser in the end zone. Easy shot, 17-13 of Rainmakers.
Let's hear that fan club.
Right now you're hearing the Henry fan club. As Dogfish offense gets their first chance with the disc this quarter. Shanka with the disc. See Boucher on the near sideline. Being guarded by Bender. See if he can shut down this MLU monster. Disc comes all the way over to Shanka on the near sideline. Finding Boucher. Lots of people clearing space for Boucher. Boucher's just been a beast for the MLU in general and of course for the Dogfish, his home team. Shanka moving the disc around. Seattle playing very much man defense, very much trusting folks like Bender to keep Boucher out of the end zone, which he does, but Boucher gets it underneath. Far sideline, 23 yards out. Shanka coming across. Shanka bids, but keeps it in his hands. Henry Fan on the sideline. A second bid, unlucky, as Bender does a fantastic job getting that disc, but it floats up, and Boucher is able to bring it in, 17-14. Rainmakers still there. Lots of space, lots of forcing one-on-ones. Not too much help, not too much switching deep for the Rainmakers. And it's just Bender on Boucher. Kept him underneath, though he did get a couple of 15-yard gainers. And then really at the end got the D. Just wasn't enough to stop the disc from reaching Boucher's hands in the end zone. Seattle offense, Pape with the disc. Looking at a pretty deep stack as they're taking turns cutting under. Finally finds Hauser with it. Hauser stuck, Tridiak's back, but he flicks it up instead to Johnny Quant. Quant moves it up to Entz. Not sure who was on Entz. It looks like people are trying to switch, but not succeeding as you see Burton try to pull that into play, unable to get there. And you find the disc in Janinus' hands. Now over to Hooker. Back to Janinus. The wind's picking up a bit, moving across and away from us. So see that disc is going to be pushed down. There's the hut going up. It's going to be floaty. There's going to be a battle. House is there first. House gets position. House gets the air. And House gets the disc. Hauser with the D. Now he's got 7 minutes. Tons of time to work it all the way back up. Full field. McKibben over to Mark Burton. Johnny Quant very open deep. It's going to be contested. And a great D there by Abram, who finds the disc, lays out, and gets close enough to knock it out of JQ's hands.
David Abram with that D.
Abram brings it in, far sideline. Gets it all the way across to McCarty. Finds Hooker. And shoots it up to Sheridan. Lots of little quick handler movement. This stall's never hit really two or even three. As there's a timeout called. Starting off with a set play. Trying to make some room, but nobody seems to come across into there until late. Where finally, Panetta comes. Moving the disc up 15 yards at a time. Making it look easy there. As the defense is struggling to stay close enough to make it difficult. Pushing back. Nice work downfield by the Dogfish, really keeping space for each other. So there's not too much chance of a switch or a nasty poach. making it very difficult for the defenders to stay on the hips of an offense who chooses when the race starts and where it goes. Disc shot quite quickly. It's going to be a race. Simons bids. Oh, wow. Boucher showing some juggling skills there. Snags it left-handed, trailing edge. After Simons goes flying past, Boucher once again finding the disc in the end zone. 17-15, two-point game, 5 minutes left. Bulls coming up for the Dogfish. Two-point game. Disc centered to McKibben. Three folks streaking deep as Hero comes across, Mark Burton. However, a poacher in the lane just stood there, knew what the plan was, and prevented it. That was Abrams staying in the middle of the lane, preventing the disc from getting Mark Burton's hands. They do finally find Burton with the disc at the 50-yard line right now. Moves all the way across to McKibben. McKibben spends no time finding Brad Hauser, who has been a goal machine for the Rainmakers. 18-15, 5 minutes left. Seattle defense pulling with a three-point lead. Defense has really already done their job. This is going to be the best pull of the game so
far. Nice pull from Ben Whipple.
Catching it about 2 feet from the back of the end zone. No big concern of letting it hit the ground and see if it's going to be out. Too risky. Disc floats a bit to Gabe Shonka, but able to pull it in. Moves it right up, working it up that far sideline. Wind has died down to nothing right now. As the disc caught on that sideline, moves it over to McGurk. And McGurk sends it up to Hecht. Close sideline to Shonka, just gained 40 yards and two throws. Shonka showing off that left-handed backhand as he finds Boucher. Boucher, they're putting a different defender on him every time. Right now you see Klein on him. All these defenders on Boucher managing to get real close. You saw a D, you saw an attempt, but none of them able to just stop him from getting the disc. Shonka in the middle, finding Hecht, it looks like. Boucher on the far sideline. As long as he's gaining no yards, that's considered a win. Moves it up. And no problem finding the sideline as Bender got a little tricked. Claps his hand, frustration. Didn't see the Dogfish run behind him. San Francisco defense, often said defense wins games. Offense's job is to score. The expectation is that Seattle scores here. So as long as the Seattle offense can do their job, Seattle defense has already done theirs, won the game. It's just up to Seattle offense not to lose it. Dogfish can make that as hard as possible. As the disc trapped in Isaac Entz's hands on the far sideline. Finds Jeff Pape. Jeff Pape, who fires it, working up that far sideline, looking for Hauser to be a hero again. And a little bit lucky as the jungle catch gets tipped by two players to a diving Mark Burton. Gonna pad the stats. 19-16, important point. Unfortunate for the Dogfish.
They the can't stop Mark Burton. Mark Burton in the end zone chases that one down.
As he gets another goal for his resume.
Henry Fan on the call.
Defense for Seattle comes out. With 3 minutes, 40 seconds left. Disc in Boucher's hands. Dogfish not really time pressed yet. Offense just has to do their job, put that disc in the end zone, not take too long, get their defense back out for a chance to win. Sends it up to Shonka, and there is going to be a lot of contact. Shonka looking for a call. No call given, as Neely and Shonka kind of lock legs, go down, and the disc sails over both of them. Eddie Feely's going to pick it up. Just over 3 minutes left in the game. Hecht forcing in the flick. All these throws so far with the force, no breaks right now. As the first break goes to Feely, who does a little globetrotter move, pops it, gets the layout assist for himself. Sends a little fan mail. Too far, Henry Fan can't get there.
Just out of reach for Henry Fan.
Of course they'd like to score, but the sloppy game's still gonna help Seattle as they are ahead. Ahead by three with 2:30 left in the game. Dogfish, once again, a man defense finding Boucher, who's really been isolated a lot of this game. A lot of the players running quite deep and almost German style, old school German style, where some of the players are quite deep, letting Boucher work the entire middle of the field, which he's doing quite successfully. You'll see him getting it about every third throw. Right now in Hecht's hands. Hecht launches it again to Shaka, this time with Henry Fan on him. Shonko looking for a foul or possibly an injury. Another right shoulder down for the Dogfish. Shonko with a history of right shoulder issues. Clock's gonna come back on as soon as the disc is tapped in for Henry Fan. Clock's on, minute 52 to go. Mark Burton right away. Moving it towards the far sideline. Pass Burton to Neely, dishes it over to Eddie Feely. And nobody over there on Simons and Fan. They're on the close sideline. The force is the other way. Wow. Almost juggled it there by Klein, who dives, pops it up, and tries to catch it. Can't do it. Minute 20 left. Boucher with the disc, but they're just going to have to put this in if they want to cover this three-point gap in the next minute 15. And that's not the way to do it, as this game is gonna wind down on a pretty sloppy point. Back to Fan. You notice the players on the close sideline are really pretty open. When the disc comes this way, it's no problem finding somebody. Floaty shot, it's gonna be contested, but Mark Burton manages to get both arms there and find Simons to bring it up. 20-16, 51 seconds left.
Ben Whipple with the ball.
Dogfish looking to catch this Ben Whipple pole, center it immediately, everybody on the close sideline. Isolating Jaeger, who gets it no problem. Lynch on it. Dewey Valentine can't stop that around. Gets over to Hooker on the near sideline. Moving all the way over, almost deep there by Abram, who wasn't sure if it was going to somebody behind him. Moving up the field quickly, got to shoot it in, there's the shot. Bender's going to be there, but it sails over Bender. Caught, nice throw. Thin window, but he hits it to bring it within 3:24 seconds left. 2017, hoping to finish it 2018, or at least 2017, feeling like your defense is doing their job, doing well. Pulled caught by Danny Tridiak. 20 seconds left. Tridiak a bit stuck as they move it up to a nice save by Isaac Entz. 6'6", he's got the long arms to get there. Puts it up, shows he's effective on both sides of the disc. Isaac Entz to Gavin McKibben. That is pretty backwards. Isaac Entz usually catching the disc, McKibben usually shooting it. And you see why. As the game ends, trying something new. 2017. First win for Seattle. Bringing them up to 1-2 for the season so far. 1-2 for the Dogfish as they take their second loss of the season, tying these teams up as they'll meet again later on Major League Ultimate.